type of food can we eat to help our health?
Thank you very much. Well, I had a research. I talked about a balanced diet. Yes. And just like I said, a balanced diet involves the basic food nutrients that we all know, which is carbohydrates, the protein, the fat, and the vitamins, the minerals, and so on. Things our body needs, and when we talk about me, I'm not talking about something. So, this kind of food we should eat, but remember, I said in a sizable portion. We have a challenge in this environment because we eat a lot of carbohydrates.
Yeah.
And when we eat a lot of carbohydrates, in the long run, it also gets stored up as fat. So we have to take note of that. So we must eat a reasonable size of carbohydrates. And when we are eating carbohydrates, we should also stay away from too much refined carbohydrates. When we talk about refined carbohydrates, we are talking about those ones that the body does not need to necessarily do too much work to break them down. As you are eating them, they are getting absorbed. So as you are eating it, it's getting absorbed. Now, those other ones that the body will need to break down, the work of digestion will have taken. All those foods, they are a process. Amongst those foods, you get fibers. Those fibers will help your digestion process as well as help your excretion process. So that is why if you are even going to eat carbohydrate, it's advised that you eat carbohydrate that has fiber, not the dense ones that have very high dense residues. Those ones that will be absorbed quickly. If you take such foods, you will not know you are taking so much in. But before you know it, you're already having an imbalance. Apart from that, we must stay away from food that are unhealthy. Things like too much pressure, all those things we eat in fast foods, they are not healthy for us. They are not healthy for us. We can eat it occasionally, but not all the time. Remember, one of the challenges we have among adults, which is increasing on the daily rate today, is obesity. Many of us are getting overweight and obese because we eat a lot of carbohydrates and fat and we don't do a lot of exercise. And this is one point I also need to point out to Christians. As Christians, we say we fast, good, we pray, fine, we come to church, but we hardly have time for exercise. As Christians, we need exercise. Because many people will just say, okay, once I come to church and I dance. Yes, dance is a form of exercise. But are you having enough? How much of time do you even come to church?
How many times do you have to dance?
So people in the church, where exactly? So in that place, some people, we are not doing enough with exercise. So I want to advise us as Christians, we need time for exercise. We need to exercise because when you are eating and you are piling it up, you are not exercising, which is a way of burning out your excessive calories, you just find out over time that you have become obese and you won't be living a healthy life. God help us.
Jesus. Amen. Listen, can you just break down those food?
The ones that that are easily absorbed.
Yes.
Okay, now let me just say this. Some of the food that we know we can easily absorb. They start from what is our soft drinks. They have what we call the last limit, or breakdown limit of carbohydrates, which is glucose. So once you drink it, it's getting absorbed. Immediately you drink it, it's getting absorbed. That is why. Now, most of our flowered foods, that we also take in form of pastries, pizza, those other things we eat, and all those fat and oil-based foods, they are easily absorbed. So as we absorb them, we're increasing calories. So we need to cut down on those things. We always advise, as a matter of professional counseling, that people should eat food that they would not absorb so much. And that's why we encourage, if you're going to eat probably a food like panellium, eat a little. Eat plenty of vegetables. If you're going to something like starch, garri, banana, Eat a little.
With a little,
I mean with a lot of vegetables.
Protein food like beef. Some of those things, they have high cholesterol. So we advise that please don't take too much beef. Because you can take your chicken without the skin.
Some of those they have oil. You know, so but now we're taking so much of it, we're building up too much oil. And then you should also take note that fried foods, everything you fry. You fry beans, you fry fried rice, you fry chicken, fry turkey, pardon me to say that. All those things, they are adding too much of fat or amount of the body. So we have to do it in moderation. Chocolate, leave it for the children. let the children take chocolate. Mm-hmm. Let them take more of the sweets and the biscuits. They are growing, they need it. But even amongst them, we should also remember that there is what we call childhood obesity. Childhood obesity is also increasing now because of too much of all this. So whatever it is, we need to restrict them, even for our children. Because of childhood obesity, we see a small, less than 10-year-old is like 3 times my weight. And I'll be happy and say, this is a problem. So it is important that we allow the children to take these things, but also know when to tell them, stop taking it. Otherwise, you are giving them money to eat. You will be spending money to treat them later.
That would be too bad.
Mm. Yeah, that's part of it.
That would help us in Jesus' name. I pray that the wisdom that the parent needs to take care of these children very well, God will give this to them in Jesus' name. Plastic rice, we've been hearing about it. Is it real?
Well, I'm not in the best position to talk about plastic rice. I believe that there are agencies in the government to ensure that the right kind of food gets into the circulation. The reason being that if there are no such things to penetrate the borders and gets to the people, then in their duties they are failed because the health of the people will now be in jeopardy. But having said that, the first time I saw that was also, I saw it on the web, on the internet, and I saw that it went viral. People were talking about plastic rice, and recently I saw somebody displaying the plastic rice, saying that we even have it already in Nigeria. That whoever did it has done a very good job. I saw some of those things. So I have not seen it. I have not cooked it.
Okay.
And I've eaten it. I know. But we also need to be careful. Even eating too much rice is not good for us. But now that they are talking about plastic rice, I believe that the agencies involved should help us look into it so that people are not exposed to things that are inimical to their health.
Thank you, sir. So what does the Bible say about that?
The Bible says a few or a number of things about our health. In the book of 3 John 2, it says, I beloved, and we shall go for things that are made prosper. Even as thy soul prospers. Remember the book of Exodus. The Lord told the children of Israel, he said, I will not permit any of these diseases which I struck the Egyptians to come upon you because I'm the Lord God your healer, as your father. And in the book of Jeremiah 22, he says, is there no barbarian here? Is there no physician here? And where is the health of my daughter? Not here. Now, the Bible in several places talks about health and ensures that we are supposed to live in health. James talks about praying for those who are sick. In the book of Timothy, Paul advised the young apostle that you should not only take what some people use as backbone for what they want to do.
The Bible says you take a little wine so
for the frequent moments. That's a discussion for another day. Now, so, over time, we will notice that in the Bible, there are a lot of issues with people who had unhealthy position. We had a woman with issue of blood who had it for 18 years. And the Bible said he has suffered a lot from the hands of many physicians. Now, if I'm supposed to look at that today, most times I just look at if that kind of woman were to fall in the hands of many physicians, the present day physician, and imagine the kind of person. So I just say that, but the truth about it is, health is an enemy. Knowledge is increasing. In the book of Isaiah, the Bible says, "By stripe we have been healed." So that means part of our redemption package is divine health. So that means as Christians, we are supposed to live a life of divine health. We are supposed to live in health. That is what the Bible encourages us. It doesn't mean that some people have not gotten healed. I'm sick.
No.
Like in the book of James, the Bible says, "Is anybody sick? Let him call for the elders." They say, if they are sinning, let them confess and let them pray. The prayer of faith to heal the sick. So, occasionally we can have that, but we should know that that is not what Jesus Christ has for us. It's possible for us to live in a state of health. But what you have said is that if we are living in a state of health, we must be doing the right thing. We must be eating the right food. We must be in the right environment. We must watch what goes on around us. Yeah, you know that a number of people, they were sick before they even died. Even in the Bible says Elisha was sick before he died. So he said by that sickness he died. Even David, in his old age, was so weak and weary. At the same time, we still have some men of God who at 120, their eyes were not dim like Moses. So I think it's all grace, and it's all about God. So the Bible makes mention of health in different ways, but I believe that as Christians, part of our redemption package is healing.
Yes.
The Bible says that by stripes we are made whole. So, as a Christian, if I continue to claim divine health, it is good. I even want it. I want the health. I don't want the healing. Because when I'm healthy, I won't need to start praying for healing. Healing means something has gone wrong.
Yes.
So, I'm not looking for solution, but when you're in perfect health, it means that there is no absence of diseases and all manner of sicknesses.
Thank you very much, sir. Praise the Lord. As we usually do in this set, we always want to have a backup from the scripture. And thank God that our doctor or pastor has given us the backup from the scripture. And you ought to know that the Bible says everywhere Jesus goes to, he always do wonders. He heal the sick. He deliver the oppressed. He did so many wonders. Praise the Lord. That is why you must know, as a child of God, your health is your wealth. Your health is very important. And that is what you can use to serve God. Anyone that is on sick bed cannot serve God the way he wants or the way she wants. So take care of your health today, and I pray God Almighty will take care of us all in the name of Jesus Christ. Daddy, we want to thank you very much, sir, and I pray more anointing in Jesus' name. You have given us your time today, and I pray God will give you more of his time in the name of Jesus Christ. The person we've been speaking with, Pastor Dr. Adeyemi Dada. Thank God that he has shed more light to all this question. And I know probably you have some question that you want to send. Please send it through our email, which has already been displayed on the screen. And also don't forget to watch us on YouTube. Don't forget to watch us on Facebook, Twitter. We have so many, Google Plus, all these programs are in place, and also subscribe to our channel so that you can watch more of our program. I am Isaiah Rukzoi. Till we meet next time, remain blessed in Jesus' name.